Okay, what are the similarities between a map and fish? And they both have scales. Okay, so hello, this is my friend Eva. She is from Poland, and she is studying remote sensing under the geography department, right?
Mm-hmm, exactly.
Very cool. And you're doing your master's?
Yes.
Now, I did look up remote sensing, and it is imaging using, like Earth imaging using things that are remote, so like satellites and drones.
Remote sensing is just sensing something remotely, so without touching. So when we are looking at something, we are also somehow like remoting it. But I'm studying like remotely, sensing it.
Yeah, okay.
So when I'm studying on geographical department, we are looking just on Earth, because geography is about Earth.
Yeah.
So what we are doing, just looking at Earth from mostly above and trying to find some, not patterns, but yes, using satellite images, drone images as well, or other images taking on by camera on planes or something. Just so interdisciplinary. Like you can do everything with it. Like you can look at plants, you can look at glaciers, you can look at sea, you can look at desert, whatever.
You can expand your mind, you were saying, mm-hmm. and there's tons of projects like all across the world that you can work mm-hmm. on in the different ecosystems. Mm-hmm. So can you kind of just like give some really cool topics that people can explore with remote sensing?
So looking at remote sensing like a tool, you can look for biodiversity in Borneo, you can look on deforestation on Papua New Guinea, you can look at expansion of desert next to Beijing, you can look at avalanche risk in Japan, you can look at at earthquake in Nepal, you can look at tsunami in Haiti, you can look at
just
hurricane.
Like everything, hurricanes.
Hurricane now in Miami, you can look at everything. You can look at oil spots, you can look
volcanoes
at
volcanoes in Chile.
Yeah, it could be cool as well. Of course, it's done. Let's say glaciers, did I tell glaciers? How fast are they melting and so on? Yes, you can look at it as well. And what's very nice, it depends on what kind of project we are working. You have to gather some knowledge from this area. So when you're working with biodiversity, like what I'm doing now, I'm just reading about mm-hmm. DNA sequencing, and it's pretty cool. But when I've been working on some glacier things, I'm just reading about glaciers and about cryosphere and mm-hmm. how does like some ice fluid stuff are going on. And it was amazing as well. And what I'm doing with my supervisor, we are looking at biodiversity of temperate forests, so just normal forests that we used to in our geographical.
In Switzerland?
Yes, exactly. Okay. In Switzerland. So what I'm doing, I'm looking at genetic diversity.
Okay.
In trees. So it's not even looking at different species, how we can recognize different species of satellite images or like other like airborne images.
Okay.
But just how to look even deeper, so how to look into one species and how to decide that this one species has different genotype than genotype.
Do you get to travel a lot
with this one? Like I told, it's very important to not only looking at images, but just be aware what we have on those images.
Okay.
And of course, we can try to figure it out somehow by models or whatever, but it would be cool to know what we are looking at. And only one option is just to go to this forest, go to this glacier, and find out, this one is reflecting like that because it's more wet, or this one is reflecting like that because it's infected with some kind of insects. You really have to go. To understand what you are sensing.
There are people who are going to
travel. Yeah, there are people who are going to Borneo, there are people who are going, or whatever.
You're a huge skier, right? I mean, you're not like we were just talking about what we would like to do, because we were just talking about how like I have this like struggle of like my kayak life and my mm-hmm. engineering life. And do you like, what do you want to do after your master's?
Okay, so that's something pretty amazing about remote sensing as well. Because what you can do, what people are doing, they're analyzing avalanche risk, let's say, just looking at satellite or other kind of remote sensing images.
Okay.
And you can look at snow cover. So since I love I just love skiing, and I would like always try to find some connection, try to find combine it, not being in double life like we already
know. Yeah,
about.
Yeah.
So there are so many opportunities just to look at things that could be very useful as well for my passion.
Okay.
So I can imagine that you can just look at amazing rivers and decided, oh, this one is more wide. I have to go there.
I have to go there.
Exactly.
Okay, thank you very much for letting me interview you. I really appreciate it. And thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions for Eva, please leave them in the comments below and I'll make sure that she answers them.
Can I also say thank you to you?
No.
So thank you to you for introducing this topic, like remote sensing. Not that many people know about it, and it's really cool. And
did you know about it when you were in, before like you found out about it? Like, did you hear about it from anyone?
Somehow not. Only one class, and it was very... It didn't show us how important, how cool it is.
Okay, yeah, so if you like this video, please like it below. And if you want to hear more from amazing women in STEM, then please subscribe. We would both appreciate it. What?
Nothing.